Today we're going to talk about Robot Console message centers and how they're used to configure your notification for message management in Robot Console. Many of you are no doubt dependent upon notification from Robot Console via Robot Alert. So rather than spending any time in the product, typically you're waiting for a message to be sent to you in your email inbox. I've actually got a couple of emails here from Robot Alert. One of them actually is from Robot Space, but this one here at the top says that there's an inquiry message waiting for a response in the QSysOp message queue for a job. How did this message get to my inbox? Let's talk about that. In Robot Console, there is a feature called a message center, and the message center receives information from the various monitoring types that are in Robot Console, whether it's message queue monitoring, resource monitoring, log monitoring, or IFS application log monitors. All the activity from this monitoring ends up going to one or multiple message centers. The message queue for monitoring QSysOp by default goes to a message center called QSysOp. On the QSysOp message center configuration, this is where you will configure your user notification, which is in the form of a GUI pop-up or a break message into the 5250 green screen. Likewise, Robot Alert interfaces at the message center level, and we can even redirect messages to other message centers or to the central robot network host center display. Let's dive into this a little deeper. The three type of escalation options you have in a Robot Console message center are user notification, which is in the form of a GUI pop-up if you have the GUI active on your desktop, or a break message in the 5250. You can send that break message to an individual, which is a user profile defined on the system, or you can define what's called a notification list. And by default, there is one that's included in Robot Console called Operators. You can see we have another one called European Ops Team, and that's configured right here in the product. And that allows you to have an escalating list of users to notify when a message is waiting for a response. Once again, that's a GUI pop-up or a break message to the 5250. To send out an alert message via Robot Alert, that's defined here under Device Notification. Robot Alert devices can be created and modified by clicking on the Finder button. For instance, here is mine. I can go to the properties, I can add devices and what are called broadcast lists. And I can include that in my notification. Finally, there's message redirection. There are a couple different kinds of message redirection that you might want to take advantage of. Depending on the monitoring that you're doing, those notifications will initially go to a specific message center for that type of monitoring, like log odd, log FTP, log hist, log ALMQ. In order to get those messages sent to your central Robot Console message center, which might be QSysOp, you have the ability to select any one of those message centers, and if the message requires a reply, it'll be redirected to that message center. Likewise, if you have Robot Network, we have the host center option, and that sends up to the central Robot Network status center. All right, let's show you what this looks like and how you can modify the escalation options during the evening hours or on the weekends to fulfill your notification and escalation needs. We now have notification from the Robot Console system tray notifier that we do have a message waiting for a reply. From here, we can do things like look at the message details, we can reply to the message. We also have notification in our 5250 green screen on multiple displays. So unlike putting QSIS Opera in break mode, with the robot console 5250 break message configuration, we can notify multiple people on multiple displays. For a bit more functionality, we can open up the QSIS Opera message center display. There are filtering options to look at today's messages, all messages waiting for a response, or all messages in our history file. From this display, I can reply to the message, and when you do take the option to reply, it will show the operations staff exactly what the correct reply values are. I can also double click on the message or go to message details. From here, I can see the message first and second level message text. I can look at the extended details, for instance, what job sent the message, and I can also reply to the message here. A very handy feature of the message center is being able to drill into the job. So by taking the display job option, I can look at, for instance, the job log. I can drill into the message from any of the messages from the job log. Likewise, using the display job option, I could look at spool files, I could look at QHIST, and so on. Finally, of course, because of the escalation to a robot alert device, I do have the message waiting in my inbox as well for me to take action. Additionally, Robot Console has a batch command that you can use to modify your escalation settings that you have on your message center. This can be valuable on the weekends or evenings when your escalation path might need to change. Let's take a look at this. The command is in the Robot Console library called rbtconlib, and the command is rbc change center. Specifying the message center name will bring up the current properties of your escalation. So you can schedule this command in Robot Schedule or the native scheduler and use it to, for instance, maybe remove the pop-up notification, because on the weekend maybe nobody is available to actually see it in the graphical interface. And then change your device notification. For instance, maybe you have various on-call lists. Let's see what this looks like now in Robot Console. So here are my settings prior to running the batch command. Let's do an update. And you can see we're no longer sending out a break message or a pop-up in the GUI, and our robot alert notification is to our on-call one broadcast list. If you do have any additional questions on modifying the escalation in your Robot Console message center, or any questions around Robot Console or any of the other robot products, please contact technical support.